As all the Immaculate Lamas of this tradition have stressed, it is very important in the beginning to adjust your motivation. So start by thinking that you're here in this occasion to receive teachings on the most profound and subtle teachings of the Mahayana. And you do that in order to be able to benefit sentient beings who have been your mothers in the past and are as vast as the vastness of space. For their sake, you aspire to reach the state of perfect and complete enlightenment, this precious state that is characterized by the full development of all positive qualities and the total elimination of all negativities. With this particular thought in your mind, please adjust your motivation.
Je mazin dan dambu lan sinan da tin da go ir du ji den go den ni oda ngobar zabar sang ji mar tsir tem ba ma to ngar ni sang ji sambari di o ji da sang ji tsir tem o da den ni ji jin ko lo ren ba sam o ji da ren ba jin da mar ko ran de ba yin du di kang ga yang ji zo zo ji nam ka dang nyam ba sam jin tam ji ji ngor wan kor ne dingar gan kor lo kor ke di ba di o ji da din ra go dingar gan kor lo am ka ngar gan kor lo ra wo di me par zo ya o ji te dan tham ba kap kap go mar ji ji di to ya si di se ji de la ni kap ke ji di ram ba ko mang bo o da thar te ke ji di ram ba mar ji ni ji ja de to ya ga da ram ba ji san song wo san di wa di da ni san ro wo ji yin ding.
If we look at the situation of the enlightened being, the Buddha Shakyamuni, although he manifested the act of becoming enlightened in the holy place of Bodh Gaya, the truth is that he had already attained the state of enlightenment many eons before that. But for the sake of trainees, for the sake of showing the mode of attaining the state of enlightenment, he went through the process of progressing along the path and finally manifesting the attainment of enlightenment under the Bodhi tree in Bodh Gaya. And having manifested the state of attaining perfect and complete enlightenment, he engaged in the action of turning the wheel of Dharma. This happened in three different stages. And all of this was done for the sake of sentient beings who are as vast as numerous and numerous as the vastness of space. And they're all experiencing different types of sufferings. They're all going through this cycle, repeated cycle of suffering and unease. So for their sake, he taught the Dharma in order to show them the means by which happiness and well-being could be achieved. And when we talk about happiness and well-being, this can be understood as a short-lived, limited happiness, as well as happiness that can be everlasting, ultimate type of happiness.
Je
And also saying the Buddha engaged not only in the turning of the wheel of Dharma, but in total in 12 different deeds of or enlightened activities. All of them were done for the sake of sentient beings. Sentient beings, that their number is unfathomable. Their number is as vast as the vastness of space. And all the suffering that all these sentient beings are experiencing comes down to one single reason, and that reason is grasping at the self, at a truly existing self. It is this ignorance, grasping at the self, that causes myriad types of suffering. All the different types of teachings the Buddha has given, the collection, the bundle of 84,000 teachings, they all come down, finally, into the ultimate point of teaching interdependence, of teaching emptiness. It is said that in the same way in this world, we might have great number of rivers, and each one of these rivers might run in a different direction, such as some of them are running towards the east, some of them towards the west, the north or the south. Eventually, all the rivers will have to fall down into the ocean. So similarly, all the teachings that Buddha Shakyamuni has given are pointing towards an understanding of emptiness. And also the great Lama Tsongkhapa in his text, which is called The Praise to Interdependence, has said very clearly that all the teachings, whether they are sutra, whether they are tantra, whatever they are, eventually they point into interdependence, they point into emptiness. So this again stresses what has been just been explained. Now, if we examine the world, the situation in the world, we see that there is a number of philosophical and religious systems. And of course, each one of them is proclaiming methods and ways to achieve happiness and well-being. But there are differences in all these systems. And the difference mainly lies on the amount of information and explanation that is given. In some systems, we have a very brief explanation. In other systems, we see that we can find more detail, more extensive explanation of how this happiness can be achieved. And also it might be that at a particular times you might have teachers who might teach more extensively, or at other times in other locations, in other situations, you might have teachers expounding a particular system where they choose for one reason or another not to go into such great detail. Nevertheless, when we look at all these systems, the main thing when we of practice is to examine them from the point of view of you, the view that is held by the system, as well as the contact. And as we say, when we look at this twofold division of our practices, we examine them in terms of view and in terms of behavior. And when we talk about view, really we talk about development of wisdom. When we talk about behavior or conduct, we talk about the development of method. There's another way of talking about these two principles. We can talk about the two types of accumulation. When we talk about wisdom, this can be translated as the accumulation of primordial awareness. And when we talk about method, this can be translated or referred to as the accumulation of merit. There is no practice whatsoever that does not fall in any of these two categories. If it is a practice, it either has to be accumulation of primordial awareness or it has to be towards the accumulation of merit.
Sanga Marchulu Gachibo Dino on that Mulam Don Dino, or you that Jordan, you number Sanji, or you Karazago Yamle, the Jalam Disangano, do you worry? Or that Jet Dembani Muntoya, Musanguya, T. Tani, that Lam Tapsin Yam, Sang Ni Sanguya, T. Sabo Tumdrin Tila, or that devotee Zukunin Traviati, Maradumda with Jamna, or Guan the Chuoko, Sonami Chili Jam, Sonami Chin. So, Nonga number them in chamber, you see, Sananda, or that Chukudi and Raviati, Sonam Jin Sosaya Tila Rogli Dingi, or that Wardus Sonny Soya Am Tapsin Yamne, Tini Giala Jedendi, Ju Tapjin Amne Giadi, Kondu Demba Namdra, or Ju Londruko Navinda was she good dingy, or Ju da the Sherabjin Amne Giala Yon.
We actually also have the similar advice that is given in the form of prayer, an aspiration dedication prayer from Aryanagarjuna, where Aryanagarjuna is actually making very clear that there are three things to keep in mind at all times. The first one is the basis, following that is the path, and resulting from that is the resultant state. When we talk about the basis, we talk about an understanding and recognition of the Four Noble Truths. When we talk about the path of the two truths, when we talk about the paths, we talk about the amassing the two types of accumulation. And as a result of that, we talk about actualizing the two bodies, the two holy bodies of the Buddha, the form body and the Dharma body. So when we look at the final state, the state of the result, this is actually what we aspire to achieve. This is the object of our practice, the object of our hopes. But this is something that will come by relying on the path. And the two types of accumulation that constitute the body of the path cannot be amassed unless one has an understanding of the two levels of truth. When we look at the two bodies, two resultant bodies of the Buddha, we talk about, as we say, the form body and the Dharma body. And the result for establishing the form body is the accumulation of merit. And when we talk about the Dharma body of the Buddha, we talk about the comprehension. We make this division between the two types of accumulation, the accumulation of primordial awareness and the accumulation of merit. And we said that one of them refers to method, the other one refers to wisdom. And when we talk about method, really, from the two types of truth, we talk about diversity. We talk about conventional means. When we talk about wisdom, we talk about reality. We talk about ultimate truth, which falls into an understanding of emptiness. So it is by understanding the two truths that you can develop the method and wisdom that constitute the two types of accumulation, and eventually you can manifest the two resultant bodies at the end. And the prayer of Arinagarjuna is, may I be able to comprehend the basis of the two truths, on the basis of that may I be able to amass perfectly the two types of accumulation, and through that manifest the resultant two holy bodies. Now, when we look at the different types of vehicles that we have, the lesser vehicle and the greater vehicle, we look, for example, at the lesser vehicle contains practices of the hearers and solitary realizers, and the great vehicle contains the practices of the bodhisattvas who have entered into the great vehicle. All of them have a presentation of the basis, the path, and the result. There might be some differences in how extensive the presentation is, or there might be some small details here and there that vary, but basically the presentation of these three aspects is found in all vehicles. And also we can see that the two vehicles, the vehicles of the hearer solitary realizers as well as the great vehicle, can be reflected into the presentation of the stages of the path. Within the Lamrim, we have the practices of the individual that are shared with the small scope, as well as those that fall in the category of the middle scope. When we look at the great scope of the Lamrim, we will find in that all the practices of the great vehicle. There is no practice of any vehicle that does not fall in this category, and there is no practice in any vehicle that would not have to be based on an explanation of the three principles of the basis, the path, and the result.
Gum
The great Lama Tsongkhapa has actually made it clear in a number of his texts, in the short Lamrim as well as in the foundation of all good qualities, that it is very important to first of all train one's mind thoroughly through the common paths, through the shared paths. And when we look at the division of teachings into sutra and tantra, the sutric vehicle is also called the causal vehicle. It is called the causal vehicle because it provides us with the causes that will bring about later results. We need to rely on these causes. In other words, we need to rely on these common paths. We need to hear, to listen to them, we need to reflect to them, we need to meditate on them, and using this as a basis, then we can continue with different levels of
practices.
The